If you watched my free series, which I called Vector Boot Camp, it's possible you saw this image at the very end and said, you know what? This sort of technical, precise work is just not fun. Why would I want to do that? I want to do loose, freeform painting. Because as you know, what I created here were all of these paths, and this was just a way to isolate individual parts of the image from other parts to facilitate the painting process. And as it became clear, a big chunk of making a painting like this was actually the preparation. Yes, half of it was done with making paintbrush strokes and texture and color and all the fun stuff, but the part you didn't see or maybe didn't expect was how much preparation allowed that to happen. Well, let me tell you a little story. When I was in college, anyone will attest to the fact that I rushed my work. Critique after critique, what I'd be told was, okay, that looks good, but give it a few more hours. My edges were messy, my rendering was rushed, and generally it had a feeling of unfinished. Now, at the time, I would say, oh, no, this is concept art, and everybody knows concept art should be done quickly. And therefore, if it's done quickly, who cares what the polish is? The point is that it's done. Well, I did not realize at the time that this was just wrong. In retrospect, I was just hasty. I wanted to finish the thing I was working on and get to the next thing. As a result, all of my work suffered. Flash forward 10 or so years, and the way I work now is very different, and I never would have predicted working this way. It really goes against my personality. I leave piles of papers in my house. I don't dust that much. I'm not an orderly person, and yet I figured out that the way I can achieve the clean edges and the controlled image and the dynamic lines I want is to take it slow, to acknowledge that making a painting is not just the color and not just the texture or these fun little details here, that the painting is a process that you go through, that it can be loose when it's a sketch, and the sketch doesn't need to be precise. This is where you get the idea going. And maybe you then do a color sketch, which is tells you a little bit more of the story, but is still loose and is not moving towards the final in terms of polish. And then once you get those ideas established, here's where the tricky part comes in. Here's where you have to slow down and lay the right groundwork. And I'll admit, it's not fun necessarily to go in here with the pen tool and to trace a railing or to, you know, follow along with your line drawing such that you can even paint this railing in the first place. It's repetitive work. It's mechanical. It doesn't necessarily feel fun like a loose gestural sketch. But that's not a reason to avoid it. If you've been dragging your feet on learning things like the pen tool or just generally working in a precise way, I encourage you to give it a try. Now, it's not for everyone. Some people will go their entire career with very loose drawings, and that's just the way they want to do it. But especially if you're frustrated with the quality of your finished products, if you want to add more detail and you can't quite figure out how, I'd suggest what you want to do is add more preparation, because then every brushstroke you make is more powerful. If you want to add a lot of polish, add a bigger foundation first, and the rest will happen naturally. Good luck.